projects. So, the adoption of the Office 365, we went back to the fundamentals of Lean, looking at people, process, and purpose. And we related back to Microsoft Speak, which is mobility, collaboration, and automation. And I'll talk to you today about how we can see how cloud can assist in the elimination of waste, minimizing supporting activity, and optimizing value in the lean projects while securing data at the same time. And we refer to this as lean assistance. So this is not a lean tool, but it's a way of ensuring that your infrastructure is actually supporting your lean project. So for those who haven't been part of Office 365, this is what Office 365 is in the Microsoft SaaS solution, but it can do more than just email. And that was an interesting thing. Microsoft mentioned at a partner event, 92% of Office 365 in Ireland is just using email. And I hope to show you today, if you are in Office 365, it's a lot more to consider. And including add-ons that you can add to documents, like DocuSign, digital signatures, Plantronics for audio and visuals, and unified communication. We're also working with Tech, which is a Xerox partner, looking at how we integrate the print solutions into the lean project. But also, you can look at other marketplace opportunities to enhance what Office 365 can do for you. So, what we did was, we went back to what we're doing today, which is helping companies look at making them more mobile, making them more collaborative, but also automating their business processes. And that obviously increases the value that Office 365 can do. So when we looked at Lean Construction Ireland, we understood that obviously most projects in the construction sector are not in one building. So unlike a manufacturing situation where you can have a big room, we had to look at how we can replicate that in a virtual situation. That's a typical Lean, and I think we've seen a lot of these types of scenarios today, big room approach. So what we're trying to do is virtualize that, because the big room scenario in the construction sector is not always possible. So what we did was we looked again at what cloud can do and see how we can enable this type of experience for virtual teams. So we looked at the lean pie, as I call it, which is essentially what lean is about, right? Eliminating waste, minimizing the non-value add necessary, but also then optimizing the value in the proposition. So we looked at the eight sources of waste that will help us incorporate what solutions are the best fit that they need for the client. So what we did was, again, going back to purpose, process, and people, we looked at the fundamentals, and we again went back to the lean pie and started looking at what elements of Office 365 in the cloud can help. So we basically looked at all these elements here. I'm not going to go through all of them today, because I only got 15 minutes and I got to time. But we will talk about a few of them, where some of these elements can help towards achieving a great productivity in your organization. So first of all, Power BI is the one element that crosses all three elements of the lean assistance. And Power BI is business intelligence. I don't know if anyone's come across it yet. But basically, it's looking at the issue that Peter Drucker mentioned. You can't measure. If you can't measure it, you can't manage it. And that's what Power BI is. It's a dashboard system for cloud, Office 365, or any data system that you have in your organization. So what it basically does, it allows us to create live dashboards for teams that are obviously interactable, and basically can drill down into different situations so you can actually find new insights to your lean projects. But most importantly, it can create KPIs and monitor performance of your lean project as you go through. So that's what Power BI looks like in the cloud, very complicated. But what it's basically doing is giving the right data in the right format to the right authenticated users. And that's very important, because construction companies are obviously under pressure to make sure the data that they're working with is actually protected, and the wrong people are not seeing the wrong information. So what obviously look at then is basically summarizing what we did into mobilizing the workforce to eliminate waste, help the workforce be more collaborative, and therefore minimizing the supporting activity, and then finally automating the value-add activity. And that's where, again, we found it was that's the easy way, as we all know, and this is Microsoft's where the two actually meet is where you want to plan to check in ahead. Office 365, we are allowed to measure, act, and automate the process to make it more effective. So, here's an interesting thing for the next pull up. And this is the concept that SharePoint brings to a project where most people send emails, tablets, buckets. And when you do that, if I send out an email to 10 people with an attachment, I now have 10 versions of the document. Where with SharePoint, if you send it as a URL link, you're now creating a single version for the project team to work on. Also, it allows co-authoring online. That's actually where two people or more can work on the same document at the same time. And that allows to virtually eliminate waste and minimize security activity with virtual teams. So, here's another technology that works in Office 365, which is basically very key from Xerox. And what that allows you to do is actually use your data that's in OneDrive and SharePoint to connect to printouts, using the right documents at the right place. It also allows you to scan documents back into your SharePoint server and give you information in an encrypted and safe way. So we're working with extra tech to be able to do this and deliver this to a managed print solution. And this is one of the things that we've found here within the automation. Automation is all very well and good unless you have task ownership. And the digital signature on a document or a report will allow you to get that task ownership and embed the actual process into your activities. So this is done. So it works with Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and allows you to create a process where you can get approval for things before they can start. When we say start, you achieve the goals you need to. So, and here's, this is the technology we use to create the virtual teams. It used to be called Link, and Microsoft rebranded it to Skype Physics. It's not Skype, so it is an integrated technology for conferencing. And it allows teams, as you can see here, to be more connected even though they're not in the same building. And allow their presence, that person who is green, ready, is actually available to take a call or an IM, to be involved in the meeting. But once you're busy, that goes to green, or that goes to red. That makes the availability of people, even though they're not in the same room, more accessible. So we extended that Skype business solution to a full virtual meeting. So the person here actually working on a whiteboard called a smart board that can be obviously worked on a different location at the same time. So that basically means you have that same people scenario without having people in the same place. And this is where we use a technology called Manager Pro for electronics to manage the headsets and the communication. And why do we do that? It is really to make sure that the behavior between online meetings is the same as the real in-person meeting. That's the problem that most people assume, that you just use the technology that would work, and we can use this technology to see, make sure that everyone's contributing to the call, even though it's virtual. So, and the reason why we do that is that's because technology is accepted in a different way by different people. And it's down to the fact that obviously some people, like innovators, will take the technology firsthand and grow with it, while others, like the libraries, will take more and more assistance to make sure they use it properly. So this is very important to look at any technology, be it Office 365 or whatever, that any technology needs to be understood in the behavior of the team that you're trying to implement it to. So here's the great problem. We have what's called assimilation capacity. And we all have a finite amount of spinning plates that we can put up at any one time in our head. And psychologists say it's about 7 to 10 things that we can have in our mind at the same time. Now that's not me. It's not me. But what is important is to recognize that people need to have capacity to take on something new by taking away the spinning plate. You can't keep adding and adding and adding new technology and not expect people to get overloaded. So it gets worse when you get into teams, which is like this, where you have another spinning plate all happening at the same time, and that's me there. But where you can use this assimilation of technology and approach to adopting technology in a way that helps teams. So finally, I'll finish up on this, on security. This is a big problem with all technology in the world. You won't keep your data secure because you have here this guy Dave in the corner, human error. And what is worse, you have these things. Now, one reason I use USB sticks now is for presentations, to help move my presentation market. That's a key thing to eliminate any new projects. You need to get data in one place, in one version. And finally, if you are moving to the cloud, you're then effectively moving to mobile devices that we all have here today. Security, when you have a mobile device, is more than just a strong password. It's a different thing. But the reality is, what we need to do is we need to manage the devices. That's what we learned from our work with the infrastructure army. But if people have controlled access and conditional wiping, then the data will be lost and they go into the wrong hands. And that's one thing that we put a lot of work into, making sure that was done beforehand. Because people are saying, I've lost my device, but I can't send them, they might have it. So, the lean assistance model that we put together basically is looking at mobility, improving communication with Office 365 to enable the virtual big team scenario from anywhere in the world. And then, remember, a lot of the companies we work with are actually working on international projects outside of their own home country. And then finally, looking at collaboration and managing the documents of a construction project. But this can apply to any sector, because all communication, document control, and then finally, mapping the value-add processes, and then using live dashboards for the performance. And I think the key thing for us was looking at technology, but also looking at people and the teams. And we heard talk earlier about teams. You've got to keep the teams small, even though the technology can allow for very, very large teams. If you try and create a big room scenario with 20 people, and try and get the effective communication, it won't work. So my recommendation is always to look at making teams effective and making this big room scenario so that there's not a lot of cross-talk in the way and everyone knows what's going on. So thank you very much. This is what we're doing with the Construction Army. It's the Construction Army is a member-led organization, about 2,000 members in Ireland. It's part of a bigger initiative around the world called the Construction Initiative. So we're very happy to hear from you.